Hello, everyone. I'm from Air Bed and Breakfast, and my idea is we book rooms with calls rather than hotels. The problem is that price is an important concern for customers booking travel online. Hotels leave you disconnected from the city and its culture. No easy way exists to book a room with a local or become a host. So our solution is a web platform where users can rent out their space to host travelers to, where's my clicker? Save money, make money, share culture, local connection to the city. And what is this? It's 630,000 user base, and we plan to target at least 17,000 of them. And there are 1.9 million trips booked worldwide, 532 million budget people are spending the money, and 10.6 million trips with Airbnb. If we get 10.6 million of it, we can make some money. How many of you guys are still paying attention? How I saw someone sitting right, this lady, yeah. What, right in front, right in front of me. She's like, some guys at the back are texting. It's okay if you're hungry. I'm hungry too. Some of you guys are like, am I in the right presentation? Right? But that's an example of how, that's an Airbnb deck, their initial VC deck that won them, I don't know how many million startup, let's just say it's 900 million. Do you think that they would have, those are the exact slides they presented at the VC. If they had presented it the way that I think most of us would present it, reading off slides like that, would we have gotten that 900 billion? So that's why we're here today. Doesn't matter how good your idea is, if you can't fucking sell it. All right? So today's session, it's not a one-way session. I want it to be interactive. You guys are always selling. All right? You guys are always on. There's no 9 to 5, right? Living the dream. I'm an entrepreneur. That comes with a price. That means you're always on. You are at magic. There are so many VCs here. There's so many experts here. So many people who might be interested to collaborate with you and all that. You guys must be always selling, okay? So you guys want to start a social enterprise. Who wants to start a social enterprise, or who already has a social enterprise? This is an interactive session. What is this? What the hell is this? I'm going home. What's... How many? Who wants to start a business? Who wants to be rich? Who wants to do good? Who wants to make a difference? Who wants to put a smile on people's faces? Don't just put up your hands because I'm raising my voice, okay? Now, what are your odds? What are your odds? You guys, maybe I'm working 9 to 5. I work on it 2 hours every night. 4 hours maybe if I don't watch Game of Thrones, you know. I hope that I can quit my job to start this venture soon, right? What are your odds? Do some maths. I think there are 32 investors, according to the email.
Tomorrow,
yes. All right. There are how many of you guys? How many of you guys participating in Magic MA 2015, you think?
Today?
Today?
Today, 500-something.
Exactly. Okay, 500 something. Let's do the math. How many investors? Come on, you guys are on your phones, right? Come on, do some math. Our calculator got app, right? So let's do some math. So how many entrepreneurs will one VC actually meet the ratio? Fine, I'll just fucking do it. Why did you give me the Thursday 5 o'clock slot, man? It's like everyone's like waiting for. Luckily, I'm prepared. Okay? So 15.6 entrepreneurs per investor. If I have to sit down and look at your deck for 1 hour, that's That's like 15.6 hours looking at decks. So they'll look at 15 entrepreneurs and a midget entrepreneur. That was a joke. How come you all laugh at my normal slides or you don't laugh at my joke? Okay, yeah. 2 days, 8 hours a day, listening to sales pitch after sales pitch. If you're unlucky, your slot might be on a Thursday at 5 o'clock. The last slot in the world. Nobody's going to buy you, you're at a super disadvantage. So 6% success rate, I've also done the math on that. So basically it's 15.6 divided by, I don't know why I did the math, yeah. Your chances of success, 1 out of 15.6 candidates they might choose, 6% success rate. If you're on a Thursday, 5 p.m., drop by half, 3% success rate. How do you actually tip the balance to your favor? I want to do a little role play now because I've been talking so much, everyone's just sitting down and all that. You guys on my left, you have $500 million and you guys are VCs. Yes, you too, sir, over there. You guys, social entrepreneurs, you really have a world-changing idea that you, if only someone would give you a chance to bring it to life. All right? Now I want you guys to meet, shake hands, exchange one sentence, two sentences, 5 minutes, move on, speed dating, just shake and get to know each other right now, role play. Are we ready? Yeah. Go! Go, 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 shake hands, meet, get to know each other. Go, 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 go! You have 30 seconds to close that $500 million sale right now. 30 seconds. Stop right there. Stop. Wait. Stand where you are. Stand right where you are. Stand right where you are. Stop flirting. Guys, at the back. Wait. Time's up. Time's up. Time's up. Wait for a while. Time's up. Yeah, exactly. What? Time is up. Okay, now, you guys on the right, you have $500 million to spend to invest. You guys on the left, your turn. I've got a world-changing social entrepreneurship idea. If only you would give me the money, please give it to me. Go! And why are you guys talking to the same guys? Keep swapping. Swap, swap, swap. You have 30 seconds to close that $500 million deal. How many investors have you met? Investors, how many ideas have you heard? If your investment fails, you're going to get fired from your investment firm. All right, time's up. Thank you, everyone. Please go back to your seats. Time's up, time's up. Time's up, guys. Guys, I Guys, I've got something. Yeah, I've got something to tell you. Guys. There really isn't 500 million, so sit down, please. guys. Time's up. Let's settle down. It's good to see the energy. Everyone's a bit more alive now. Yeah, exactly.
Guys, they have no money, guys.
There is only one real investor in the room. Are you sure you spoke to the right person? How many investors did you speak to?
One.
Investors. Okay, let's start with this side first. Hygiene check, right? How many people did you meet?
One.
Do you remember the ideas? Well, actually, I kind of hope they actually met more people so they could actually... But everybody only remembered one. Okay. Let me ask this lady over here. Can you tell me in one sentence the best idea you heard? So obviously no money, right?
Yeah.
This gentleman over here. What was the best idea you heard? Do you remember a name? That's cool.
Is it?
Okay. Good job, Tudung lady in pink over at this side here.
Actually, I'm one of the entrepreneurs.
Awesome.
I managed to speak to three. This is like speed dating. I just introduced my business. And in terms of whether I get the money or not, I'm not so sure.
How did you introduce yourself and your business?
I introduced my name,
yep.
What I'm doing, and where it is.
Cool. Investor over here, this gentleman here, did you hear any ideas that you want to invest in? This is not school, don't worry. I'm not going to, oh man, it's my turn to talk. It's cool. Everybody has to talk and speak up in this session, okay? Because it's Thursday in the evening. I'm really tired. I had a presentation this morning. I didn't have much sleep, okay? So I'm not the only one talking. Okay, everyone's going to be talking.
He actually runs a VC firm, so he's a bit of an investor.
Oh, you exposed the mole. Will you invest in the business you just heard of?
Not really now, as right now, because
okay.
It's just an idea for now.
Okay, fail. No 500 million for you. How about you?
I talked to a group of gentlemen on the side here.
Would you give them 500 million?
Yeah. Why? Well, I mean, because I'm generous. But,
well, thank you for your donation. On video.
They're upcycling hardware, so electronic stuff.
So it's like Lao Yat?
Not really, no.
Okay.
Do they do that in Lao Yat?
Yeah.
Really? Oh, okay.
Alright, so now we reverse, we start from here. You guys on this side, investors, right? Investors. You did a role reversal, right? Okay. So Mr. 500 million... Dollars?
Would I didn't get a chance to spend my money.
No?
Yeah.
Tough. What about you?
Dollars,
of course.
Rupiah.
Yeah, so I spoke to Amina Khan, the one who was willing to invest in our business. So
I love it. Cronism, very good. Well, it's called relationship marketing. Another presentation on this, but this is how it works in Asia, really. Would you invest $500 million in the idea you heard?
Yes, because I spoke to Jennifer. She's into education online. So I think
Asian nowadays, they have lots of gap. So what she's doing has lots of potential.
Okay, so she's in the short list after your meet. Good job. Who else? Who else? Did you hear any investments that you would like to put in? Any ventures?
Yeah, AJ, he wants to come up with an ecosystem or a platform to have all the social entrepreneurs on one platform so that people can have access to it. And
is it like a Facebook group?
No. a huge platform. Who's doing what in Malaysia?
Okay. Yeah. Would you put $500 million on it? Everybody's bro doing this thing. Cool. Yeah, collaboration, that's right. Okay, so it's really good to see the energy level really pick up. You guys met each other and you all mingle and talk. Imagine, tonight, are they invited for the barbecue or anything?
Yeah, you were invited as well. Everyone's invited.
So,
be very generous.
Barbecue, everyone's going to be there. What are you guys going to talk about? Game of Thrones? So always be aware. It's not just the killer slide, it's your killer sales pitch, right? So today's presentation, they told me to come in, and this is your topic, you just gave it to me. So obviously I'm from advertising, I'm not a startup, I'm not techie, I have Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, the usual stuff, I can't code, I make people's part money for a living, you know. So what would I know about these things? So I asked the expert, Google, right? How to prepare a killer pitch deck, let's see. So 474,000 results in 0.33 seconds, and I looked through all 400,000 of them because I'm so dedicated to this talk. And most of them actually, 8 out of 10 of them actually say that you can get it done in 10 slides. Those 4 slides I presented earlier from Airbnb, they're actually examples, case studies on what you need to present in a killer pitch deck to VCs. So, you guys should know this. The format is this. Intro, problem, solution, market validation, market size, product, business model, market adoption, competition, competitive advantages. And once you get used to presenting your slides and all that, you're free to add and subtract and all that. But I realized that format and structure is one thing, but the sales pitch is very important and the context of it. So when I looked through the Airbnb deck, I just tried to ask myself, I mean, how would I sell it? How would I, because I sell stuff as well. I sell ideas to clients, and clients are bored, they have lots of money, they have 99 things to worry about. Besides your advertising campaign, and they have to listen to you sell your ideas. So it's very important to tell a story. Tell why you exist as a venture. And to tell a story that's entertaining. I'm sure VCs are the same. They fly in from all over the country. They're jet-lagged. They sit down, they listen. They've got their wife on WhatsApp, their husband's on WhatsApp. The kid just failed exam. I've got an email. I've got a crisis. I run 5 other incubation stuff. You take a photo of me, man. You're taking a photo of each other over there. Heck. So, okay. So the first slide. Now this is an interactive session, and I'm going to walk around the room, and you guys are going to take turns presenting. We're going to try and see if we can do a very first prototype. Gee, I like to use that word because I'm in magic, right? So can use prototype. In advertising, just say, do a draft, lah. Okay. So about prototype. Let's see if we can prototype your very first 10-slide presentation by the end of this session, okay? Now the first slide is the most important slide because that's your intro. If you read articles about body language, people click in less than a microsecond. People can actually tell whether they trust you or not subconsciously. They did the research, I look at you, I like you, and their hunch, their gut feel is actually very right. How do you cheat them of that gut feel and actually sell them something so that they can open the door for your business to come in? So this first slide, we're going to title Find Your Why. Okay? So This is actually a module, a theory that is put forth by Simon Sinek, and he has a book called Find Your Why, actually. And I really like the talk. It's a TED talk, 10-minute TED talk. It's fantastic. And I'm just going to try and simulate that. So most companies, most brands, they tell you what they sell. I have a car that is cheapest, fastest, nicest. Or for example, if you're Samsung, I have the introducing the Samsung Galaxy Note 20, highest spec AMOLED glass, 20 gigahertz processor, 8-core, hard-core processor, whatever, most specs, lightest in the market, fastest in the market, best battery life, and it's very user-friendly. Oh, no, sorry. You want to buy, yeah? That's how they sell. They throw everything at you, Samsung, right? Let's compare it to Apple. Apple goes about it the other way. They say, we believe in changing the status quo. We believe in thinking differently. That's why our products, from laptops to phones to watches, they are beautifully designed, not just superficially, but to work around your life. Simple to use, user-friendly. By the way, we make computers. Would you like to buy one? So people buy into Apple because of their why. A perfect example is today's iPad Pro, stylus or pencil, right? I mean, Microsoft Surface, they had it 3 years ago. How come it's like a big whoop? So Microsoft Surface, we've got the best spec laptop, we've got a stylus, Apple don't have stylus, we're gonna buy. But how come Apple did it 3 years later? Everyone said, wow! Wow, you guys invented this, invented it, fantastic! Shut up and give me my money. Take my money. It's because they started with a brand that said, why? That's what they believe in. So Nike, for example, just do it. But what essentially are they trying to say in every piece of their comms? We believe that if you have a body, you're an athlete. Just do it. Put on my shoes and start doing it now. Airbnb. Travel is better when you're with friends. No matter where you go, you have a friend in that country, it's more fun, right? Come join Airbnb. Air Asia, now everyone can fly, liberating, democratizing air travel. Very simple. My Taxi, or Grab Taxi now. We don't want to just be a taxi, we're not just an taxi app. We want to revolutionize the transport industry of Southeast Asia. That's our why. Okay? So your first slide. You guys got paper, post-it notes, anything? Get cracking. You have 5 minutes to find your why. And it's a very simple exercise. You probably won't get it right in these 5 minutes, but I just want you guys to have a think about it. Remember your speech just now to your $500 million VC. What is that why that you tell them? Imagine if you're Apple. At Apple, we believe that design can empower people's lives. If you're Apple, you would say that, right? What would you guys say for your social entrepreneur, for your social entrepreneurship? Remember, 140 characters or less, okay? Simple slide, opening slide. I believe everyone has a chance at education. I believe that the blind people have so much to contribute as ideas for the internet. I believe that homelessness is just a phase that they go through, and it's not a permanent destination. I believe that proper nutrition is the right of every human being. Good. Slide one, guys. This is slide one to three entrepreneurs, or three VCs. Each of them will probably give you some money to start your venture. Why should I give you that money? Okay, you guys can continue at it if you guys are still cracking. Those who are ready, I would like to have you guys stand up and read it out loud. Hi, my name is, I'm from, and we believe. Who's ready? Go, you. You were about to stand up anyway, so. Empower Malaysian community through hand-dyeing. Okay. My challenge, my pushback to you for that is, that's what you do. That's still what you do. Mm-hmm. Why are you doing that? Empower Malaysian community through hand push batik. Mm-hmm. Hand-dye batik. Why? Why do you want to empower Malaysians through that? Is it because that it's an art form that should be valued? We believe that there's so much value in our local arts. We believe that our indigenous people have so much to offer in terms of arts. We believe in making Malaysia a more beautiful place. We believe that Malaysian women can make the country a more beautiful, can make you a more beautiful place. What we do, we sell you hand-dyed batiks that are craftsmanship, and how we do it is through our online platform. Would you like to buy some? We believe, sorry, what did you say again? We believe that we, it's 5 p.m.
We believe we can empower women.
We can empower women, right?
Malaysian women, yes, vulnerable women.
Okay.
Good. My name is Christine. We believe that arts bond family and friends. We believe that sometimes it's time to go non-regional.
So you believe that connections are better face-to-face, right?
Sometimes.
Mm. No. You believe in something, you cannot sometimes. You have to be... Understand,
yeah.
That's why it's already a fact of life, so you don't have to say sometimes. I will have to go Facebook and check in anyway. So we believe that the most important connections are the one you have face to face. Right? Go! What? Oh no, I just work for someone. So. I'm skiving off work, actually.
Okay, my name is Rosanna, and I believe every poor person has the right to wake up on time and be connected fairly to the world.
I believe every poor person
has the right to be helped on time.
To be helped on time.
And be connected fairly to the world. It's about my app, my coming app that I'm...
I believe that poor people should have the power of the internet. I believe that poor people should have the right to the power of the internet as well. Yeah? Yeah. Cool. So I just tweaked and crafted it a bit. Oh, okay, more, okay. We're really running out of time though, really. Are you guys okay to hang on till 7? Yeah? Because, I don't know, this is my slight one. Oh my God, guys. Good, good, everyone. We believe every child deserves to be safe, deserves to grow, yeah. Grow up in a safe environment. Good, that's very good. Okay, guys, I know you guys want to share so that I can give my input to make it sound nicer. I've got my email at the end of this. I want you guys to put together what you have. Just connect, and we can talk. No worries, okay? I don't sleep much. So, now, just a throwback to 15 minutes ago when you guys did that VC session, and if you guys actually had this first slide in mind, is your sales pitch so much stronger? Would you open more doors? Would you have someone say, oh, that's interesting, tell me more? Would it actually get people? Because VCs, they look through so many slides every day. Would you, in that one slide, oh, that's interesting, I want to hear more? Do you think that you're one step closer with this finding your why? You won't get this today. This is a crash course. People pay millions, brands pay millions of dollars to find their why. Okay? So it's a trial and error. It's practice. You practice with your friends, you practice with your peers, you tell them. If they say, yeah, that's good. And remember, you have one sentence to do this. So practice. It's a very important slide. I am from this brand, I'm from Magic Academy, and I believe in empowering. Everybody has the power to do good through the internet, for example. Practice. Okay, so we move on to slide 2. Remember slide 2, when I presented, it was the problem. These are all the problems listed there, right? So this is the main mistake I see for a lot of people, even professionals when they're presenting. When they have the slide there, they put out the words and they do this. So the problem is price is important concern for customers booking travel online. I can read, right? I'm sitting there. You put out all the slides there. I can read faster than you can talk. By the time you're at the second point, I've already finished reading it, I'm bored. Move on. How do you actually keep their attention? And that's cool. If it's important, you can pick it up. So how do you keep their attention? So the first tip is for overall presentation. The focus should be on you, not the presentation deck. Focus is here, not there. This is supplementary. Okay, you are holding court. You have to make them fall in love with your idea. Sorry, I'm just a bit... Okay, so the next tip is, this is a rule. In marketing, the rule of threes, you see a lot of people, power, precision, performance, it's always rule of threes, okay? So even in decks and all that, we just try to keep it in threes. To keep it simple, that's the maximum anyone can remember for a slide. 3 points per slide maximum, okay? But the most important thing is, how do you tell this slide in an interesting manner? So I call this slide 2, the problem slide, I call this the TED Talk slide. I'm a big fan of TED Talks because fantastic format. I'm so amazed at people like marine biologists telling about the sex life of amoebas. And I'm like, I sat through 15 minutes of that. You know, geologists talking about the composition of rocks and how they change the temperature of the world and why some people have more hair because of this type of rock. What? You know, really, the topics in TED are very vast. But they have one thing in common. They have a formula. They have a secret. They even have a book. And if you guys can find this book, download it or buy it. TED Way of Presentation. Fantastic. They can tell a tough astrophysics story in 15 minutes. But they always start with something. And I noticed something. They start with a problem, but they tell it in the format of a story. So... this is how Airbnb, probably, I think, would have sold it. You know, when we first started out, we were shit broke. You know, we're just three guys sharing an apartment and we couldn't afford the rent. So we had 3 air mattresses and we just posted it on Craigslist. And wow, we've got customers coming in. So when we went to South by Southwest, we decided to prototype this system. And we set up accommodations. We realized a lot of participants at South by Southwest didn't have accommodation. And so we set up, and we had a full capacity booking over there. What we realized was that we became friends after that. So hotels make you disconnected, but our ecosystem actually created a community. So no easy way exists to book a room with a local or become a host. So most people, they just put their rental on Craigslist for monthly rentals. But what about short rentals? What if we turn every room into a hotel room so you can make extra money? So that's how they probably told the story. So the formula here is, for this slide, the problem slide, find your story. Here are a few examples. It could be a personal account. You know, that day when I tried to tie my shoelace, I forgot what were the steps. And I had to go to YouTube to look at the steps. And maybe there's a better way, for example. maybe you overheard someone's problem. You know, that day when I was at the cafe and I saw this lady trying to cross the road and no one was trying to help her. I tried to help, but I was too shy. And I thought to myself, why? So I have this is my solution. You know, that day I was watching the Iraq war on TV and switched between that and Amazing Race. I kept switching. And then I had this idea. Wow, wouldn't it be great if I turned it into a movie, reality series, and war? True story. Which movie was this? 500 million. I think it was Hunger Games. Came by this way. That's a story to tell. So now, next slide. Have you guys started? I see some of you guys picked up your pens. Think of your story. This is your problem. List out your top three the top three problems that your idea will solve. And build a story around it. Find one problem your idea wants to solve first for now. Every time a homeless person wants to take a shower, he has to go to a petrol station. I wanted to help him, but I thought it was smelly and I didn't want him to put in my car. Or I scared people laugh at me. Is that a problem? That's a story, right? What else? I saw at the back of supermarkets all the expired goods. They just throw it in the dustbin. And I asked them, what did they do with it? They say, oh, we just throw it away. Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah, but I started late. It's Timothy's fault. You know, I had a presentation to give and they forced me to take a group photo at 6:30. That's the problem. Yeah, so I have an app for this. Okay, guys, who's ready? We've got to speed this up. So you guys can just start writing. But if anyone wants to just jump up and just throw the problem and tell a story to practice it, show me.
I hear it from society today, English not proficiency on youth and development.
What's a story for that? You hate it when?
Society blames youth and development on English not proficiency.
Okay, tell me a story behind that. Make it personal. Personal story. It's okay. You can present in Malay. No, I mean, it's your idea, right? Just present it. Your personal story. That day, I had the same idea as this Norwegian guy. Blonde hair, blue eyes. And just because his name was Sven, wore a suit. they bought his idea instead. I had the same idea. Why? Why should I be judged, my ideas be judged on English? And I realized that there are lots of Malaysians judged because of their lack of proficiency in English. Why is that? Is it a disability of society or myself? I think that we... Story. I know it's a lie because I'm a storyteller. Okay. I don't know your story, but all I'm saying is this is an example of finding one incident in your life, amplifying it and making it a discovery that is your personal cause. Because when you make it personal, you as an audience, the VC as an audience says, wow, this person really believes in his venture. He champions it because of what he has seen firsthand. He champions it because it's happened to himself. He champions it because, you know, he knows what the problem is. That's the essence of it. Who else? One more. List out your problem in point form since you don't have a PowerPoint slide. Stand up, please, so everyone can see you. Thank you.
Hey, I went to work at my dad's oil pump farm in Southern Ireland, and I found out that all of them, including my dad, so I end up and doing.
You got my attention. You definitely, I'm sure you got everyone's attention. Everyone's like, wow, don't know what to say. I can't wait. Yes. I can't take the group photo, man. I'm sorry. I'm staying for the team. That's a hardcore problem in your face problem. Paint a story for me. Tell me a story. That's your slide, right? You just read out the slide in the problem slide, right? Yeah, so now tell me a story. You're on stage now. That was your slide, right? 1 in 10, what? The youngest. Okay, that's fine. So, my comment to that story is still very factual for me. You're narrating it like a news article. Yeah. So, I need you to say this. You are in the epicenter of this problem. You are a war journalist. You have to tell your personal account of the thing. I was there at this kampung, and this girl came up to me and said, oh my God, I didn't know that five guys touching me was rape. I've been raped. I didn't know. They didn't know that. She broke down crying because she didn't even know she was raped. See the difference? I was there, and she told me. As opposed to, there's this girl who goes there, and then this. You get the difference? You see the storytelling power of the importance of telling it firsthand? That's what you guys need to do. Yeah. You mean you were there? You mean that's what the people said? Oh my God. You know, you need to get that emotion out. All right? So these are all the tips for slide 2. Slide 3. Okay. Yeah, 3 out, we are 30% there. So this is, again, a very factual slide, because this is what you have to leave behind for VCs, right? A web platform, these are the solutions. The solution must be benchmarked to the problem. Correct? So price hotels, price, you can save money. Hotels, you can make money instead of, letting hotels make money. That one should be, okay, they mixed it. So no easy way to exist, to book a room, that's the hotel's point. Hotels leave you disconnected. Share culture. So there's a direct match between the solution you offer with the problem you presented. Okay? Now this slide, I call this the Steve Jobs slide. So in this deck, you'll see a lot of characters and all that. I want you guys to Google, YouTube search these guys, watch how they talk, how they carry themselves, what they say. Steve Jobs is fantastic at making ideas that were done before sound like they did it themselves. Fantastic. This is the world's most popular video player. It's an MP3 player, but you can play videos. Magical. I cannot do it. See, Steve Jobs, Dan Powell, he said exactly the same words. Like, seriously, Creative Labs or something, a lot of Zen player, they have all these MP3 players from Japan. They've invented all these things before. How come he could sell it to so many people? I think he sold this he tells the benefit to the end user. I think that's the tip here. So, save money, for example. So imagine a web platform that cuts the cost of travel so that you can spend the money instead of on accommodations, you spend it on experiences. Isn't that what travel is all about? Save money. Make money. Imagine a way that will make everyone who rents a room a business owner. Imagine the kind of ripple effect we have on the economy when everyone has a way to make some side income. From students, to families, to individuals, everyone, not just hotels. We are democratizing the hotel industry for you, you and you. Make money. Share culture. What better way to discover a country than through the eyes of a local? A hotel, you'll never get that. And that is the magic of Airbnb. Fantastic. That's how Steve Jobs would probably sell it. He paints a picture of that. So, exercise, group time. So, match your problem with a solution, point by point. You have 1 point, match it with a solution right now. 2 points, match it right now. 3 points, match it right now. And focus. Focus on your... where is it? Sorry. Focus on the benefit to the end user. Find your Steve Jobs in this slide. Okay, let's go. Here's a thought starter. Here's a tip. Every benefit you have, start with the word imagine. So transform facts into basic human benefits. That's what advertising agencies do. You guys got to learn a bit of that for the sales pitch. Another example is talk to VCs. They're not just people with money standing there and all that. They're people too. If you can look them in the eye, walk towards them and say, imagine if you could save a child's life just by picking up your phone. Wouldn't you do it? Let's go. Imagine if there was a way people without the internet could report cases of sexual abuse within 1 hour. Imagine if old people could actually program and start their own apps instead of just sitting in an old folks' home knitting. how many more ideas could we have? Imagine if every illiterate child had FaceTime access to one person in KL for half an hour a day. What would that do to their education standards? Imagine. Thanks, guys. Any other volunteers? Anyone want to share their Steve Jobs slide? Hang on, sorry. Do you have a mic, please? Or you can share mine. Bro, share mine.
So, yeah, I'm doing medical tourism.
Sorry, medical tourism, okay.
Why?
Start from slide one.
Okay. So when I was I'm doing sales, so I visited Bagans right recently. So I visited my friend's house. So the parents are living alone. So when I went there, both of them are actually watching TV without talking to each other. One at this side, one at the other side. So I'm just thinking, so if my friend visits them often, they will be probably happy with the grandchildren and all them, visiting them on a weekly basis and all that. So I think by
yep, the
so
problem.
The problem is parents are living alone in the hometown. Most of us are staying in the clan valley and all that. So what if I make your trip, I pay your trip to go visit your parents? It's just like Airbnb mixed with Grab car and I pay you to bring a tourist, pay you to the house. Something like that.
So imagine if people could... Now the problem is most people can't visit their parents because they can't afford to, because they need to stay back and work, or the cost of transport is too expensive. The solution. Now imagine if you could still earn, what if you earn money for every trip that you make back to your parents' place? What if you could bring a guest down? It's a very simple way of, okay, cool. Okay, so for me, I think your biggest story is you believe that cyclists, there should be more cyclists in the city, right? So more cyclists in the city means less cars, means a healthier environment. So the only way you can do that is if you can keep cyclists safe. Maybe for me, right, your story should be about KL, the car-free ride day. It was beautiful, it was colors, the air was fresh, it was fantastic, people were laughing. Imagine if that could be every day. Imagine KL car-free ride, what could be every day. Wow, you know? Sorry? Okay, this one take bus. What else? Okay, I mean, we're not going to perfect it right now. That's a good start. I'm just bouncing ideas off you. Because every slide, you need to bounce ideas and practice and rehearse and see the reaction of people. Last one, any volunteers? Go. Sorry, I'll come to you the next one as well. Go for it, quick. Okay, cool. No worries, it's okay. I'm sorry. I just got standing this way. Sit in front.
Okay, so
Okay, a little bit of context. What's the problem? Share what is the problem first. Cool.
By using the aquaponic system, which is the symbiotic relationship.
Use the slide format. Slide one. Why? Go.
Okay.
One sentence. Don't give me the whole thing. This is only slide three. Come on, tell me your three slides right now.
The story? Oh, okay.
No, not the story. Before that, the why. Tell me your why.
Oh, so everyone has the access to good.
Good. I believe that everyone has the right to the access, has the right to good food,
yes.
Right?
That's
slide two.
The slide two is kind of interesting because it's not a story, it's more of a graph.
Just go. Okay. It's okay. No judgments here.
Slash
graph. Wow. Okay, interesting.
Yeah.
I love that slide. I love that slide because, give a big hand for that one. Did a good job.
It was very raw.
That's cool. My only comment, it's a bit too long. Keep it to two verses, done. You juxtapose it with a few pictures, show real problems as you talk about it. And then you have to sum it up. So that's the problem in a poem. Memorable, insightful, clear. I get it. So what's your... Get it. Slide three. Go, slide three. Your slide three. Don't forget the slide three. Imagine.
Sorry?
Imagine.
Oh, yeah. So imagine that.
No. I can't. It's very factual. So my comment to that is, it's okay. The whole idea is that everybody can do this. With enough practice, with enough discipline. If you use the word imagine and you say, okay, now you have a cabin around. So imagine if everybody... You know, the problem is people in apartments and all that, they don't have gardens. So if I tell you to grow your own vegetables, people can't do it. Now imagine if I can tell you, even if you live in a 700 square feet apartment with no space, you can have a garden to grow your own organic food and grow your own fresh fish. Imagine that. Yeah? Okay. Example, work on it, okay? All right, slide four. So market validation. Now, you guys probably can't read the words here. I can't read it very well as well. Only because I can't find the actual exact PDF from Airbnb. But this slide actually just talks about now. I have seen that there are 630,000 listings on couch surfing, which is sort of like their most direct competitor, Airbnb. 630,000 listings there. Nobody's making money out of it. I have 17,000 listings on Craigslist, which is the easiest way to get massages and you know, quick free accommodations. 17,000 listings like that. In this slide, you tell the VC, wow, there's a lot of people, there's a lot of opportunity here. So you told people the why, you told them the problem, you told them imagine the solution. Now you tell me, how many people are going to buy into your idea? Right? So if you have your smartphone, if you have internet right now, if you have your problem, and if you have your solution, and you have a venture, right? Google and find me a stat that is so big to tell me that that's the potential reach of your product. If you have it at the back of your head, even better. If you don't, cook up a number and tell me, tell it to me in an interesting manner. I call this slide the second-hand car salesman slide. Or you're an idiot if you don't see the deal here. So this essentially is exactly what I would have, like what I presented earlier. Just say that there are 600,000 couch surfers there, sharing their couches for free. Imagine if each one of them shared their couch for 3 days a week. They would have made 5,000 ringgit, and Airbnb would have made a cut from all of these 630,000 people. Wow, I'll be crazy if I don't give you some money. There are 17,000 listings on Craigslist for New York, but this list is not clean, literally and metaphorically, because, you know, some of them are fronts for other dodgy businesses. People don't believe and trust them at all. We can provide a site that is rated, reviewed, reliable, and trustworthy for both parties. Okay, big market there as well. So this exercise, so here's an example of how you can do it if you have those two competitors and the market space. Sorry, I missed out this example. So, you know, you can actually rent it out for free, or you can actually take a risk at renting this apartment, but there's no guarantee that it's a reputable place. There's no service that provides both. If you can't find that in time, just find a market validation. How big is the marketplace? I did a map of the Klang Valley, and there were the ratio of apartments to landed property is X amount. I did a research of how many hypermarts per housing area, how many shopping malls per housing area, and how much they spend. These are just 20%, only 20% of the cases are reported. 80% of the cases end up unreported. Sexual abuse. What are the repercussions of that to a society in 50 years' time? Now, if you do some research on the population of Kuala Lumpur during Raya and after Raya, during Raya, only 10% of the population are left. Now, imagine if they tripled their trips and made 50 ringgit, how much money would that generate to the economy? Imagine if now there are 500 indigenous tribes, each of them with a unique art form. Imagine if, and there are a total population of 9,000 housewives in there, who could generate, that's the size of a factory for Uniqlo. Do you think that they can't be a powerhouse, for example? Anybody ready to share? Sorry, I'm really going very, very fast here. Am I going too fast? Okay.
This is just the size of the market, right?
Tell me your cause first, so I have context again. Tell me your why. Slide one. Just tell me your slide one.
Why?
Yeah.
Creating impact through simple solutions. Basically, it's a tapioca farm.
Sorry, tapioca from?
Tapioca farm using unemployed youth as the driver.
Unemployed?
Youth.
As the drivers?
Yeah, as the farmers.
As the farmers, okay. That's equivalent to, example, I'm just adding on second. That's equivalent to 7 Boeing 747s. For example, you just give a context to the metric ton thing.
That's sort of, equivalent to 70 Ferrari cars.
Yeah, 22,000 football fields, whatever, okay? Just examples like that. You contextualize it, good. So you, that's one half of the secondhand car salesman. So you need to tell them, imagine how much money we can make if we sold it ourselves, or the income generated. Yeah. Imagine if we exported it, become a net exporter instead, for example. Who else? Good. This side. You. Sorry. Next on you. Why? Start with your why. Now imagine, slide 3, imagine. Sorry, I'm just being a bit impatient here.
So imagine if you could actually make money from your youth clothes.
Fantastic, very good.
So,
next slide.
You might be able to buy new clothes, or you might be able to donate your clothes, or you might be able to give away your clothes, but there's nothing in the country that provides a platform for you to make money out of your used clothes.
What's the secondhand car salesman? Oh, that was the secondhand car salesman slide. Not statistics enough. There's not enough stats for that. So there are, for example, let's say there are 30 million Malaysians. 70% of them are the age of 20 to 30, the highest consumers of fashion industry. Their average income is this amount. Now imagine if they could make some money out of it. 70% of 30 million, that's your market valuation, validation. That's a big market. I will invest in you. Sorry, this gentleman first. Do it in the sequence that we presented. What's your why? You see how that was a really good format. The four slides, the 4 points, very clear. Why?
The fact is there is a silent killer lurking in the country. 63% of people have at least one risk factor of MCD. This can actually destroy productivity. Sopso now spends $630 million a year in compensation. Country cannot meet Vision 2020 if the productivity goes.
Good. I need to stop you right there first, sorry. Because what you have presented right now is you've jumped ahead. You're telling how you're doing it. So tell me your why you believe that Malaysians, the healthier Malaysia is a more productive Malaysia, something like that, right, with diabetes. So the problem, what's the problem? The problem is? Now imagine if there was an app.
Now imagine if
That's not big enough as a market validation.
Okay, right, correct. Now, because this is the first one, we are then, once this is successful after 6 months, we're going to be given access to a database of 30,000. And if that is successful, then the government will give us access to 2 million patients. There are 2.6 million in that database. Imagine if this is done, at 2.6 million, we are 10 times bigger than the two largest diabetic databases in the world. My sugar has 230,000. Business models that we can do, selling the data, targeted ads, and for the government to know what's going on the ground.
Okay. Okay. The market validation is good. My comment is, I find that there's a disconnect between why I should buy into your venture. Is it a business reason or is it an emotional reason? I feel that the emotional reason, there's a bit of gap there. So we'll talk about that later. Are you guys from the same, you guys are a team? Okay. So you felt shy about putting up your hand too much, right? So you pass it to her, right?
There are 11 million children in Malaysia. Only 0.03% of the cases are reported. We can spend, of abuse cases that are reported, we can spend 100 ringgit to prevent the child from abuse or spend dealing in the next 10 years with increase in social ills, increase in crime, unproductive
. Okay, that's a bit of a mouthful of numbers to put in. I think market validation, there are 11 million reported cases. Is that what you said?
No, 11 million children in Malaysia.
Oh, sorry, there are 11 million children. Only 0.03%. How many is that in numbers? Okay. There are 30 million people in Malaysia. One third of them are below 12. Imagine if 0.036% of them are abused, sexually abused. How many is that? 1,000? 2,000? 2 million? That 0.036 is 2 million? How come you get it? How come I didn't get it? Okay, my point is, keep a big, broad stroke market validation. Don't go into too much detail. That's too much details for now. But I get it. 30 million, one third of the population below 12. 2,000 abused children, is that little? Is that a small amount? No. We're going to bring it down to zero. Yeah, maybe I haven't seen the rest of the story yet, but you need to build your case very well so that you don't have to go through details of the numbers. Facts you can leave behind, your documents, but you are presenting your case. Slide 5, the opportunity. So, okay, this is the slide where you guys do the sales pitch. The earlier slide was the market validation. 30 million people, one third of them are children. That's your opportunity. 30 million Malaysians, 2 million diabetes cases. The amount of cost to SOCSO is this amount. What if we could reduce it to 1 million? What would that do to the economy? So this is the market size, and this is really the opportunity. Now, this slide and the slide before, you see like, it becomes very natural for you all to veer into the next slide. It's very logical to do that, right? So it's very important to break it up, compartmentalize, because if you tell too much, it can get too much into the facts. So the reason why they break it up into market validation, this is about the context. Context of the market, this is what's out there. These are the people out there. The most important slide is this. Even if I get X amount of them on my product, I have this amount of people. There are 30 million Malaysians out there. One third of them are children. Even if we get 50% of the parents to report the cases, we have 50% less cases of sexual abuse. Wouldn't that be impactful? For example, market, so the opportunity. So apart from numbers, these two slides are very numbers driven. You need to tie it back to your cause and your problem very, very closely. Otherwise, like your example was a perfect example, the last example about the child abuse, all I heard were numbers, like blah, 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 blah. You lost context already. So it's very important to always tie it back to. So call this the Zuckerberg slide. He uses data, he breaks it down into bite size, and dangles a humble, realistic, but hugely profitable carrot. Your opportunity on data, database, this is where the next slide comes in. Now imagine if you can have this access to this database and also fund and reduce the incidences of diabetes. So left brain, right brain, this is where you go into that slide. According to Google, there are 1.9 billion trips booked annually. And those who book on AirAsia flights or on budget hotels and all that, 532 million of them. Even if you get 0.05% of the market, that's 10.6 million users. And that's what we aim to get for Airbnb. So to break it down to the bite size and to show that there's an opportunity for your product. Can we do that? Can we try that? So this is an example of a template here. Find your Zuckerberg slide. There are XX Malaysians who are doing this. If XX percent of them are on your startup, we're talking about X amount of users. Can you break it down into this simple sentence? That's essentially what you wanted to say in a sentence. Simplify the data. Whew, 6:45, guys. Are we all right? Are we tired? Are we? Am I boring you? Am I moving too fast, too slow? I'll share this with you. I'll just email it to you. Or what was that? WeTransfer, is it? Something, yeah. Who's ready? Four more to go. Oh yeah, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, 5 more. We're gonna have dinner at 7:30. Sorry? Come on. Okay, I'll move. Fine. Where's Ihon? Can you get them to reserve 50 plates of lamb while we do this workshop? Yeah. Okay, we really have time for one lucky person who puts up his or her hand now. Anyone wants to try? Give this a shot? Use this exact sentence, practice. Okay, well, get back to me on this then. Who has the data? Who has facts? Can you try and do your stat again like this? Because you threw in a lot of data, right? You weren't doing your exercise. Yeah. There are 11 million children who are below the age of 12, maybe. 17, okay. If X amount, 4,000 of them report their cases, that's 4,000 lives saved. Right? We're talking about how many people? You're selling a platform, right? Yeah. You know what? You know what? I think, right, this group here, I think it would be really nice if you guys start to keep in touch with each other so that you guys can practice these slides with each other. You guys have all set into, you guys have, Is that an inside joke? You're laughing at something? Okay. You guys have sat in the entire session. You can do a stock check of each other and check in and rehearse. I think that's a really good idea. And network. Give me your Mr. Tapioca. Give me your Zuckerberg slide. You sound like you got your Zuckerberg slide, man.
Okay. Let's try.
Let's try.
There are 10,000 unemployed youth in Malaysia right now. If even 5% of them start a farm of 1 acre, that means we are talking about a group of production of 500,000 metric tons a year.
Money, in terms of money, I think. That's giving them from, unemployed, zero, tie back to the objective, zero, unemployed, these are unemployed, $0 a month. If they all sell and do this job, we will have given jobs to 4,000 of them, each earning about. Yes, you can. So this is variable, depending on you guys got to, we're all adults here, right? Okay, so this slide here really is the play acting slide, okay? Everybody has their process. You, sir, just actually told me your process earlier, halfway into it, because I can see that you're very passionate about your idea. You need to establish all that before you go into. Now is how you do it. How are we going to do it? All right, this is the prototype idea. There is no formula to this. It's just practice. And the best person to practice, I call this the Johnny Ives slide. So what's the difference between Steve Jobs and Johnny Ives? Johnny Ives is a designer by trade. And if you see his videos, when he talks about Apple products, he's very passionate. It also helps that he has a British accent. Everything that I had designed is beautifully designed to be perfectly beautiful, absolutely amazing. Wow, bye. So we don't have that. But we can have the enthusiasm and... What? Boleh juga. I'm sorry, can you speak Malaysian English? So it's very easy at this point because you are so familiar with your product that you go, it's already 6:50. All right, the VCs are really tired, they're really sleepy, Thursday evening, they're missing their lamb. And now you're telling me about your product, you better give me a fucking good reason to stay behind and listen to this, okay? So most people make the mistake of being very process-led. So step one, people log in, connect to Facebook, correct? We want to build database, so we have them fill up an address page. After they fill up the address page, they access that page, and then they interact and choose their city and blah, 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 correct? So Johnny Ives would say, it's very simple, imagine all those type of stuff. It's wonderful, this product is perfect. Oh my God, you have to buy this. So this is where you really have to amp up the passion. Energy level is low, you're halfway into your presentation. People might be bored. But this is where you have the chance to pick it up again, because at least if you're not clear on your first five slides, this is where, maybe he's not too sure about all that, but he's passionate about his product. Yes, this is the Goring slide. You have to be passionate, and you have to show your... So... Shit, these slides are so low in resolution. I have a confession, because I couldn't find a PDF high-res of this. Every example of this was a snapshot from another presentation, so I wanted to get my designer to redesign the slides, but we were really busy, so sorry. Okay, so I'm going to try anyway. So imagine if you come in, you can just search by city. If you're on your mobile, it will detect the city you're in right now as well, and it will connect you to people that you want. If you're a person selling a space to rent, you can match it. I'm a married couple, I only want married couples. I'm a single woman, I only want single women. I'm open for any type of guest, things like that. It auto matches. I have a budget, I have a location, I can see your profile. And If there are any security concerns, don't worry. I can see ratings of the previous tenants. I can, and as a person renting out my place, I can see the history of this person. Oh, he has traveled around the world. He should be quite cool and chill. So you really got to sell this because this is your product. And I don't know if you guys have a product. Sometimes it's tangible product. Sometimes it's not. You have a container model, right? The idea. Imagine if you bring a scale model container, you put a little... Imagine if this 500 square feet, imagine if you build it and you open it up and you show. Or use Lego. Imagine if you use Lego to build a set and share. VCs can look into it and see, oh, 500 square feet, this is what I can put into it. Be creative. Because it's a prototype, you don't have anything. If you guys are hungry, I won't blame you guys for walking out on this presentation, okay? I'm sorry, we're running really late. Who wants to try? So there's no technique to this. This is really trying to sell it in a way. Go for it. Here. Face the camera from here. So I can actually sit down for a while.
Imagine that I just graduated. I've been looking for a job for like 3 freaking years. I'm depressed. I want to kill myself because I feel like I'm like worthless. But then suddenly, some angel came and he gave me a piece of land, 1 acre, just 1 freaking acre. And he gave me the sticks. He told me just stick it in the ground and just wait for it to grow into castable roots. I can sell it for $5 per kilo. In 1 year, I'd be like making $5,000 a month. Would that be amazing or not? And if you bought that and sold it for $10 a kilo, how much would you make?
Good sales pitch. Very convincing even without a prototype. But so... But there has to be a platform, right? Someone, a way for the kids to apply for this or something, isn't that? What, how would the program go? No, let me think about this. You bring a tapioca there. This tapioca, what is this? This can generate food, this can generate this and that. Yeah, starch and all that. Imagine if they can do byproducts of this. Imagine if they just plant it. Imagine if they can do that. If I put this in your hands, put it in the hands of the VC and says, now I have just turned you from $0 income, depressed, drug addicted, maybe resort to crime youth into a person. This tapioca in your hands, this is $1,005 a month. You can, that's it. Okay, business model. Amir told me this is the part where actually we are all really bad at this because essentially we're not money men, right? And I'm sure if I ask you guys to do this slide, I don't know how many of you guys have this slide, but honestly, the problem of social entrepreneurship is this. A lot of them are not sustainable business models. And despite, no matter how noble the intention of it is, you have to find a business model for VCs to invest in. So, sir, this is where you come in with this slide on the database part. Jump in too early on the database part. You confuse me because you're talking about something, you make me feel, and then suddenly, imagine sell database, I feel guilty. But if you talk about your story, your problem, your solution, market validation, opportunity, your walkthrough of how you're going to do it, now, how? If you give me $500 million, this is what I can give you. Now you talk to their head. Talk to their hearts first, now you talk to their head. Okay? Make sure there's a hook. I think that platform is very interesting because it's the Facebook model. Give it for free, you earn it somewhere else. Right? And that's one way social entrepreneurship should work. Because where is the ROI for me? For example, let's say, a very good example is the sexual abuse organization. Why would a VC give you $500 million? is it just for charity so you can save Malaysia? No. I have bosses. I have investors to that. I have to show them that I give you 500, you're going to give me 550 million at least. What is the business model? 5 more minutes.
There's also another hook there.
Yeah.
If you look at it, we're working with a government agency. Our acquisition cost is zero. They're doing all the screening. So what we have to do is also have a revenue model to give some of the research definitely goes back to them, but some of the revenues goes back to them because our acquisition cost is...
Cool. The most important thing is this one. The fee you charge. If you're charging something like your model, if I just get people to sell things on my page and we charge them 1% for shipping, we do the shipping and we charge, we would have made, for example. So think of the profit, how are you going to make money so that the investors know that. So this is the Chinaman slide. I think this is a, anybody knows who is this? So Mr. Anthony is, I think, one of the most successful entrepreneurs in Malaysia. Asia, the world actually. So he owns Grab Taxi. I think it's a very simple slide. It's use a baseline, you have to do a research on what people normally charge. Do you charge less? Do you charge the same? Do you charge a premium? What is the baseline? So he would have used, you know, when I call the call operator to book a cab, they charge me 2 ringgit for the cab because I booked the cab. But I paid another 1 ringgit for the call because I have to call once, I have to call twice, call operator, call back. So the actual cost for me booking a cab is 3.5 ringgit for on average. With this app, I charge them 2 ringgit flat to book a cab. They have saved 1.5 ringgit. That's how we make money. Right? That's just, of course, post-rationalization is very easy. This is an example. Use a baseline of what people would spend for an equivalent product. So I just gave that example earlier. Find your Chinaman in this slide. Find a simple common man dollar question. I give you $1 and you have $2. Yeah, exactly. What is the baseline that people usually pay for a product like this? If it's something totally new, like for example, your example here, and you said it was Airbnb for old folk, for people to balik kampung, right? So how much does it cost someone to travel from Penang, KL to Penang? That's the common man dollar question, right? 50 bucks. Imagine if I gave you 50 bucks instead for every trip you were in Penang. So for this 50 bucks, we get a cut because you rent out your place for a tourist, you bring them back, and you earn 50 ringgit from there. And we take a commission of 5 ringgit. Now there are 2 million people traveling to Penang. If we get 10% of the people, then there's 200,000 people on our program. 200,000 times 5 ringgit. That's what? 10 million? Something like that. So make it very simple. Slide 8. okay, this is my favorite slide because this is a question that I think a lot of people will ask enterprises. A lot of people are, especially social enterprises, of course you all care about something. That's why you went into it, right? There's some good into it. But let me ask you, if I give you this 500, essentially this question is, to answer the question of the VC saying, I give you 500 million, how are you going to make this money? How are you going to make people be aware of your idea and buy into your product and even adopt it? Okay, so this is a very complicated slide, but actually it's very simple. He broke it down, Airbnb broke it down into 3 pillars. This is what the events, that means this is what they're going to do themselves. These are the partners that they're going to work with. And this is the platforms they're going to use for free to advertise this is a platform that we're going to advertise our product because people are already renting out places for them. So I call this the Don Draper slide, all right? Because this is where you think of your marketing and advertising and promotions. Just think of those 3 pillars, personal, partnerships, and platforms. You need to have one pillar. What are you going to do? I'm going to go to Martrade. I'm going to go to every tour agency. I'm going to go to every old folks home. I'm going to go to every the Hokkien Association when they have a family day, whatever. This is your calendar. This 12 months, I'm going to go talk to everyone. Okay? Partnerships. No, that one cheat lah, my cheat mode. You must find relevant. Okay, let me think. So for your example, you're gonna go work with. What can you work with? Muda? Can you partner with Muda? Can you partner with who? Who are the existing brands that sort of can? Yeah, correct. Things like that. Platforms. Don't just say, I got a lot of friends on Facebook, so I'm gonna blast it out and create a group and ask them to join my group, right? So platforms. I'm gonna use Facebook and do promoted posts to target this segment of people, parents with kids, for example. I'm gonna use search SEO. For example, I'm gonna buy ads in porn sites. Imagine that. I'm gonna buy ads in porn sites because I know dads watch porn too, right? Highest video streaming in Malaysia is After Midnight. Come on, what is it? Game of Thrones reruns? Sure, that's what they call it. So, yeah, so very simple, right? Personal, partnerships, platform. Okay, no time for that now. Just remember that. Keep it very simple. Sorry? Personal, here's a tip. Show a calendar of events and roadshows you plan to market your products to. So in these 12 months, I know tourism is having the roadshow here. I booked a booth here. In Selangor, there's a to promote tourism. I'm gonna go there. There's going to be Airbnb is gonna host the conference. I'm gonna put a van outside selling t-shirts of my product, whatever. Show them how passionate and active you are and you're not just waiting to give money, to get the money from them. Partnerships. Show that you know the marketplace. Show that your marketplace, your idea can be supported by a network. Some social enterprises are easier for me to identify than others. So it's very subjective. Pharma. Pharma, father, mother. that pharma. So platforms. What platforms and how will you use existing platforms for your customers? All right, you need to do some basic homework on how to advertise on Facebook, how to advertise on Instagram, how to use search, how to optimize search, how do you put a banner in YouTube? Things like that. Just find simple techniques. Do some research. All right, that one will take another 2 hours. I think there's another session by Prashant. He's actually, you guys can go there now. He's actually having a parallel session. Finish your day. Okay, get his deck. Ask for his deck, okay? He's the expert in that. Basically, don't say I have a lot of friends on Facebook and I think 2,000 of my friends all buy it. Right? So, okay. Wow, this slide. Okay. Competition. What do you mean, how do you get beneficiaries? Yeah, that's acquisition. So, this. Yeah, that part for your example would be here. This is how you do it, right? So it's actually on this slide here. You have to talk about the program already. This is that's your ecosystem. Okay, so nearly there, guys. Two more slides. Then it's on to lamb. Okay, your competition and how you stand out. So most people will say, we'll put up a PowerPoint, or this slide will be in bullet points. This is my competition. There's the recycling center, there's this other NGOs there, these are all my competition. But I think this is a good opportunity to do, I don't even know what this slide is called, this chart is called. Anyway, this is where you want to be. So for example, Airbnb, right? You need to find two of your best traits. We're affordable, we're online, Airbnb. That's the essence of it, right? You do a chart. You want to be at this part. What are your competitions? Hostel.com. Okay, they're affordable. Wait, sorry. Okay, this is online transaction. So they're online. And what's this? Shit. I'm sorry. Ah, okay, yes. Airbnb, we're affordable and we are online, right? So Airbnb, we are the most affordable and we're the most integrated online platform. Hotels.com, they're online, but they're not affordable. Craigslist, they're kind of offline because you have to pay when you meet the person, right? Offline, but they're kind of affordable. Rent, OB, and all these, they're expensive and they're offline. So as you can see clearly, Airbnb is the best product in its category. So in this slide, every battle is won before it is fought, says Sun Tzu. And I don't know why the autocorrect keeps changing into Sun Tao every time. Just notice that. Make the competitors look weak even before the battle has even begun. Okay, so your product, what are the two main benefits of it? Let's see, how about your product? What are the two main benefits?
Two main benefits to the people. They will get the sustainable income, and they also can get the job that is flexible for...
Okay, so one bar, the horizontal, profitable. What's the opposite end? Not profitable, right? Here, it's flexible, not flexible. So what are your competitions? Let's say it's a factory worker. They work in a factory. It's sustainable income, but it's not flexible. So they cannot take care of their children. What other income is there? Making lemang during raya. So that's very flexible, but not sustainable. You get the idea? So you map it out, and you have to be in the upper right corner and say, this is where we stand out. Okay? This takes, it sounds very simple. It takes a lot of practice. We don't have time now. You guys can try. You guys can check in with me. I promise you, I'll get back to you eventually. But yeah, I promise. So practice your 10 slides, network, and share it with one another. Share it with me as well. Sorry? Yeah, I'm not done yet. I'm just saying. I'm just apologizing along the way. Yes. So, yeah, so the group work here. Let's try it. Let's give it 1 minute on our own. Let's try it. Let's give it a go. What are your two key benefits? Write it in a horizontal and vertical chart. Two key benefits. The other end of it, what are the opposites of that key benefit? So you should be at the upper right corner of this chart. Mark your competitors. If you can't find this two key benefits and competitors and you don't feel like, or you feel like everyone's on this chart, you really have to relook at your business model because there's nothing differentiated about your business right now. Okay, anyone want to give it a go? There must be some competitors. You must find, if there are no direct competitors, there will be some parallel, some other organization doing something for youths who are unemployed. That's your competitor, right? If they're not on your program, they'll be on their program. That's a competitor. That's not pretty direct on farmer, agriculture-based CSR. Maybe, but it can't be, because your problem is based on your target market. Do you have a question?
Does, yeah. it, does it have to be a direct compensation?
No.
So I would say mine is affordable and stylish.
Yep.
Bundle jobs are affordable, they're highly.
Correct. Yes, that's a good formula. Now you match it. So,
what
Fabrica.
What do I put as not affordable and not stylish?
Pasar Malam.
Yes.
Right? They would still spend 10 ringgit, 20 ringgit in the Pasar Malam for a top, right? Okay. This is actually a very simple slide. Summary. We are an NGO that believes that every child is should have the right to be safe, to grow up in a safe environment. We believe that 0.05% is still a percentage that's too much for this country. We want to bring it down to zero. So what is your competitive advantage? We are free, we're accessible, we're offline, we have a phone number, we don't need internet for you to talk to us. There's a network of people that can help around Malaysia. What are your benefits, your benefit summary? Of course, first to market is a very important thing to put. Even if you're not, find something about it that you're first in. All right, we're the first tapioca. All right. First travel tourism program that benefits Malaysians, the everyday Malaysians. Host incentive, actually your model is kind of similar to this. So the benefits are kind of similar. So you need to find something that actually, like let's say if you have cultural context, for example, you know Malaysians, you know it's in three languages, whatever. So Airbnb, they broke the rule of threes, right? Actually, you don't need ease of use. You don't need the database here. I think design and brand is not necessary for now because you already showed it. First to market, there's incentive for hosts and maybe profiling. I think those three are the most important, if you ask me. So I believe in making happy things. I tell stories and make people fall in love for brands. And by the way, I make ads. So if you guys get 500 million, come talk to me and we'll do a campaign, all right? So thank you very much.